G'day team, if you're going out there and you're going to buy a rod and a reel separately, here's how you match them up. Some people get it wrong. I have purposely done this the wrong way. So if you're heading down this trail, you're heading in the wrong direction. Now this is a 20 pound surf rod. It's around 8 to 10 kilograms. I've got on that a small 3000 size Stradic. Look at that. It looks silly. It's not going to work. In fact, the rod outweighs the reel straight away, like that. So we'll put that one down. This reel is a Sakura Shimano 8000, the saltwater model, and it's on a little Katana 2 to 3 kilo rod. It goes the other way. So basically, the reel's too heavy for the rod. It's not going to work. If I put that reel on that rod, it's going to be ideal, and vice versa. That little Stradic on this little light Katana, it's perfect. In fact, what you need to do is check out on the rod blank, there'll be a rating of line class. And then have a look at the reel. There'll be a rating of line class. You match those two together and you're heading in the right direction. Now, if we have a look at some of the combos here that have been specifically made up just for you here at Anaconda, you'll find that they are a perfect match. This is the Sienna 4000 on a beautiful quickfire 5 to 8 kilo. Look at that. It sits absolutely perfectly on my fingers. The weight is ideal. And of course, that reel line class, again, 5 to 8 kilo in your braid line. It's gonna be ideal, perfect, even mono. The heavier outfit, this is a Shimano TLD 25. And we have the Solstice XT. That's a 15 to 24 kilogram rod. So it's a lot heavier, but the line class on the reel that I can read right here tells me 15 to 24 kilo. So if you marry up, again, the line class that's written on the blank of the rod to the line class written on the spool of the reel, you're heading in the right direction. Good luck.